High cortisol, I think, is what everyone automatically goes to when they feel the feeling of like anxiety or that wired but tired feeling. Often might experience this in the evening time where you feel tired, but you also feel like so wired at the same time. And you should be going to sleep and you know that that's not correct. Sometimes people might experience anxiety or like sweaty palms, heart racing, elevated blood pressure, hair loss, acne. Those can all be symptoms of high cortisol. I would say most people aren't as aware of acne and hair loss being symptoms of high cortisol. I think that it's a bit easier for people to identify that feeling of like stress, anxiety, rushing, you know, not having enough relaxation in your day is more of a feeling of high cortisol. But what's really interesting is that we probably, I would say, see across the board like a pretty equal split between high and low cortisol. And what oftentimes people don't realize is that low cortisol is just a response in the body from a long period of high cortisol. So like a lot of systems in our bodies, right, is our body tries to overcompensate and it's like always trying to protect us. And so it's like, okay, you need me to keep pumping out more stress hormones. I'm going to keep doing it. And then eventually at some point, it's like, I'm tired. I need a rest. Whether you want to rest, I need to rest. And at that point is when we stop making adequate levels of cortisol. And so on the internet, you probably see this referred as like stage 2 adrenal fatigue. It's not really like a medical term. I try not to call it that because it's not really that your adrenals are fatigued. It's just like an adaptive response that the adrenals have just stopped making as much of the hormone because you've exhausted all the resources of overproducing it. And so oftentimes we see people in more of this chronic state of high cortisol that it's actually showing up as low cortisol, but they might still have a lot of similar symptoms to what someone might experience with high cortisol levels.
So is it something that you can even self-diagnose or do you really need to go and get a test?
I mean, testing is really helpful because it tells us more of the picture of, is it high or is it low cortisol? So we know how acute or chronic this is. And it's also helpful to have other components than just cortisol. So for example, generally, when you're producing a lot of cortisol, it's going to start taxing the adrenals in other ways. So your adrenal glands is what I'm referring to when I say adrenals. They're like these two little glands on top of our kidneys that are what pump out stress hormones like cortisol and epinephrine. But they don't just make stress hormones. They also make hormones like sex hormones. So we make a pretty good amount of testosterone there. You make androgenic hormones like DHEA, you make androstenedione, eticholinolin. These are other hormones that function very similar to how testosterone does as well. And so they can be a lot of the cause of why someone might be experiencing irregular cycles, hair loss, acne, not necessarily because it's the cortisol issue, but because the androgens that are being made in the same location are being impacted. So it is helpful to do testing that doesn't just look at cortisol, but really looks at all of those adrenal hormones together so that we can really deduce maybe why you're having the symptoms and then how to treat those imbalances.
So this might be like an old wives' tale, but I always thought that you can tell that your adrenals are taxed by having dark spots under the inner part of your eyes. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like face reading. Yes. Is there a way to look at your face or look at your body and see that your adrenals are being taxed? Or is it just a feeling?
Yeah. I mean, most of the time people, there's a kind of a wives' tale, I would say, but I think there is some truth in it that is something that people can see. I would also say like early wrinkling or like more plump loss in your face, because you do lose collagen when the cortisol levels are chronically elevated. So we can see, you know, like early wrinkling. You can even see like early graying as well, which oftentimes takes time for your hair to go gray. But if you're noticing that that's happening at a more rapid rate, then that can be a symptom. And then oftentimes a lot of like puffiness too. So a lot of times you could have like more of a round face or just like water retention, especially in kind of like the jowl type area, or just overall like water retention on the body, to where like if you were to, you know, lean up against a counter or something, you would see an indentation on your arm once you removed yourself from the counter.